Hi, it's Sudeep Bose, Bose Law Firm. Let's talk a moment about the allegation of criminal activity. On a personal note, about a year ago, my wife came home. She's an eye doctor by training, has to take 66 home every night from where she is employed. She's an eye doctor. She wanted to get home really quickly. She had a bad day, and she was stopped on the side of the road for an infraction. It was a ticket that she was given, a uniform traffic summons. It was for changing lanes without a proper indicator. Improper lane change. It was given to her by the officer. The officer could have given her a ticket for reckless driving, could have given her a ticket for something more serious, but gave her the ticket for the improper lane change. But she was upset. My wife was upset. And she thought all kinds of things, but one concept that I needed to correct at the dinner table with her was that it's an allegation that she improperly changed lanes. The same way that if you have a ticket for reckless driving, DUI, or something else that's written on the uniform traffic summons or on paperwork from the court, those are all allegations of criminal activity, okay? And that is a far cry from a conviction for the same thing. Now, what's the difference, Bose? If the officer thought that we weren't doing something wrong, then we wouldn't have gotten the ticket. So that means that likely we're gonna get convicted. Nothing could be further from the truth, because there is a large leap, a very long leap, between alleged criminal activity and a conviction for the same. The prosecutor has to prove beyond a reasonable doubt each element of the crime that you have been alleged to have conducted, that you are alleged to have done. And is it always the case that all of those elements are proven beyond a reasonable doubt? Absolutely not. So not all cases in which you have received a ticket will end up in a conviction. And certainly not all cases in which you have been arrested will end up in a conviction either. So the idea is to review the evidence that has been lodged against you, collected by the officer or the investigator and lodged against you. If the prosecutor can make out his case or her case beyond a reasonable doubt, you will be convicted. But is it that every case ends up in a conviction? Absolutely not. Everybody has to do their part. The officer or investigator is doing his or her part by investigating criminal activity, suspicious behavior. The prosecutor must then do her part by prosecuting the case, prosecuting the case against our clients. We, as defense attorneys, have to do our part, look at the evidence that has been procured by the officer or investigator, and put a different twist to it. Put a different lens on to look at the evidence differently and to make certain that the prosecutor's case that he or she has in her hand has been investigated properly. When I was an officer, it was my job to investigate criminal activity. As a defense attorney, now it is my job to look at the evidence that's being procured by those officers and investigators to make certain that our clients' interests are upheld. Then the last person's in the mix, the judge and/or the jury, depending on the level of court that you're in and the facts and circumstances of your case. Whether there is a judge or jury, their jobs are basically one and the same. It's a trier of fact. Will those individuals on the jury panel find you guilty? Will the judge find you guilty based on the motions and based on the evidence and based on the work that's done by defense attorneys and prosecutors in the court of law? That's your day in court. Don't fumble your day in court. Espouse the fact that we have a contentious system, an adversarial system of justice, because when two adversaries, the prosecutor and the defense attorney, go head to head, that's the facts and circumstances which lend itself to the truth. The prosecutor has his or her side, the defense attorney has his or her side, and in the middle, somewhere in that middle, is the